Hi, and welcome to Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help you admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Here is your host, Dr. and Evangelist K.L. Rich.
Hi, and welcome to today's podcast of Narc Abuse No More. I pray that you are having a blessed and wonderful week so far, and that the remainder of this week will continue to be blessed for you as well. Stress-free, narcissistic-free, abuse-free week. We don't want that going on in our lives. And so I pray that you have had a blessed, stress-free, narcissistic-free, abuse-free week so far, and that the remainder of this week will continue to be so as well. But if not, we're going to be talking about a few things today. Again, my name is Dr. K.L. Rich with Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help you admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Yes, they do. But before we go on with today's podcast, I would like to invite you to visit us on our website at www.narcabusenomore.org. Again, that website address is www.narcabusenomore.org. And on our website, you'll find valuable information regarding narcissism, relationships. And if you have missed any of these podcasts, all you have to do is go directly to our website and listen to us from there. Now, just to let you know, we are on every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 9 a.m. Central, and that is on SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Spreaker, Google Play, iTunes, CastBox, and Deezer. We're also on Amazon Audible, Rumble, Brighteon, and the Tube. That's why we're on YouTube. So you have a variety of different platforms that you can listen to us from. But if all else fails, all you have to do is go and listen to us on our website at www.narcabusenomore.org. Also, just to let you know, we are going to have a new podcast in addition to this one starting. And starting in January. Yes, in January. We're going to start the podcast in January, and it's going to be called Veterans in Christ, Veterans in Christ. And so we're going to be dealing with a lot of different issues with regards to veterans, active duty, talking about benefits, PTSD, depression, a lot of different mental health illnesses. We're going to be talking about suicide prevention. We're going to talk about a lot of different things, CMP exams, disability benefits. So you want to check us out when we start that podcast. And just to give you a little snippet of some other stuff you're going to be hearing, because we're also going to talk about military news as well.
Come on over. Come on over. What's not over? What's not over? So put your weapon next to mine. Put your weapon next to mine. Shoot them all down the line. And we'll shoot them all down the line. I shot Insurgent One. I shot Insurgent One. Did that one just for fun. Did that one just for fun. So put your weapon next to mine. Put your weapon next to mine. And we'll shoot them all down the line. And we'll shoot them all down the line.
And that is a little bit of a cadence that's from this guy on YouTube. He's called, his name is Jeremy Fleming, and he has a lot of cool cadences that's on the Tube. So you can check him out on the Tube. All right, what are we talking about today? Today I want to talk about love. Many people are in relationships that are not loving relationships. And a lot of people are seeking to be in loving relationships, but they're going in all directions except the right direction, with understanding what love is. A lot of times when you watch the movies, it has, oh, well, there's love at first sight. Well, I don't believe in love at first sight. I believe in attraction at first sight. Okay. Attraction at first sight is what I see. But love takes time to really get to know that person. I'm not saying you got to date them 10 years or whatever the case may be. The thing is that in order to get to know someone, you have to spend time with that person in order to know, do they even have the traits that they can love you just as you desire to love them? And this is something that is important for us to pay attention to. When you say, I love that person, or that person loves me, are you really getting the love that you deserve? Are you really getting love? Because oftentimes when people feel like they're getting love, they're actually not. They're getting anything but love. And we often know when it comes to narcissists that narcissists do not know how to love. But also people that are going into these narcissistic relationships sometimes don't understand what love is too. Because if you understood what love is, then you would know that that person who is beating you, that person who is emotionally abusing you, that person who is verbally, sexually, spiritually, whatever type of abuse, you would know that that is not love. And no matter how much you love a person, you can't make them love you back. You can do everything you can to try to get them to love you, but at the end of the day, love is a choice, and you have to choose to love that person. And if that person is not loving you, and you're putting all you can in this relationship, but you only getting abuse in return, then guess what? The abuse that you're getting is far from love. And so you might say, well, you know what? I really don't know what love is, because many people don't know what love is. They don't know what love is. And so I always love to go to 1 Corinthians 13. And you might say, well, I'm not a Christian or whatever the case may be. I want you to listen to me. I pray that you will turn your life to Christ if you have not. But even if you are not a Christian, you still need to know what love is, because guess what? In God, there is love. In God, there is no abuse. God does not want you to be abused, but you need to know what love is. So whether you're a Christian or whether you're not, I want you to listen to this so that you will know what love is. Because some people have been abused by those who claim to know God. And guess what? If you're abusing someone and you claim to know God, guess what? You don't know God, because God is love. And so therefore, you can't love someone and abuse them. You can't love someone and violate them. You can't love someone and disrespect them, because that is the opposite of what love is. And so I want to go to 1 Corinthians 13 and starting with verse 4. And it says, love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. And I'm going to stop right there, because I want to go back through some of these. And because many of you might say, well, I'm definitely not getting what is described here. And if you're not getting the type of love that is described in these verses, then guess what? You are not getting loved at all. Sex is not love. Attraction is not love. Abuse is not love. Misuse is not love. Devaluing someone is not love. Belittling someone is not love. Ridiculing someone is not love. The Bible says in verse 4, love is patient. And when we love someone, we want to be patient with them. You might say, well, you know, I got to work on my patience too. I have to work on my patience, okay? But the thing is, in my working on my in my patients or on my patients doesn't mean that I'm going to be abusive to another individual. I'm going to take time. I'm going to get to know what this person wants, what this person feels. Their feelings do matter. I want to know what they're feeling so then I know when I might be doing something that may not be in compliance with their feelings. And so therefore, I want to take that into consideration. So I'm going to be patient in order to get to know this individual, in order so that I can properly love this individual. Love requires patience. A relationship requires patience. Cities aren't built overnight. Rome wasn't built in a day. It takes patience. Love requires patience. And you might say, well, you know what? This person is not patient with me. And that could be just a simple flaw with just, you know, no abuse attached. But then when you have abuse attached, any little thing that they feel that you've done wrong and they're blowing up at you, whether it's verbally, whether it's physically, that is not patience. Love requires patience. The next thing, love is kind. Love is kind. You can't be kind to someone if you curse them out. You can't be kind to someone if you're abusing, misusing, manipulating, devaluing them. You can't be kind to someone if you are not taking their feelings into consideration. Kindness. I'm not talking about just to get something that you want, and that's a form of manipulation. But you want to be compassionate. You want to be giving towards that individual. I'm not talking about love bombing, where you're giving a gift and then at the end there's strings attached and then boost. You know, it's as it says, love and bomb. No, it doesn't go hand in hand. But then when you're dealing with narcissists, they'll do an act of kindness, which many people consider the loving part. But then at the end of it, there's the bomb. There's the where it blows up in your face. So that's where love bombing comes from. No, love is kind. Love, it does not envy. When you're dealing with narcissistic relationships or possessive, jealous, toxic individuals, you know, they're envious of the people that they're around. They're envious of their gifts. They're envious of their talents. They're envious of how they are with others. This is not loving. Many people say, oh, well, you know, well, they're jealous. And it's a sign that they care about me. No, that's a sign of insecurity. Love is not envious. And if you have that envy spirit or that jealous spirit, you have to pray that off of you and ask God to help you to remove that, because that is not healthy in the relationship. Jealousy. One thing, the Bible lets us know that God is a jealous God, but that's not jealous of us. He's jealous for us, which means that he's jealous to protect us, want what's good for us, want the best for us, doesn't want the enemy to come in and harm us. So not, you don't want someone that's jealous of you. You will want someone that's jealous for you. That means they want to protect you. They want to make sure that you are not in danger, that no one is harming you, that no one is doing anything to you that will cause you pain, which includes themselves. Love does not boast. You have, when you have this narcissistic mindset, it's always about me, 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 I look at me, or I'm going to take credit for someone else's achievements. I'm going to take credit for what someone else has done. I'm going to take credit for the hard work that someone put in this project or in this relationship or whatever the case may be. The narcissist seeks and thrives off of taking the credit from someone else onto themselves. And so therefore they will boast about your achievements only so people can gloat, and well, not gloat, but so that people can celebrate them. But it's not about you. Love does not boast. Love, when you're a leader and you're a loving leader and a good leader, and you're a humble leader and you're a submissive leader, and you're a humble servant as a leader, that means that I'm going to make sure that my team gets the credit, even though you are the leader. But you're going to say, I'm going to give my team the credit, because if it had not been for this good team, then I would not be the leader that I am today. But because I have a good team that stands behind me, that helps me, therefore I'm going to celebrate them. Love does not boast. Love is not proud. You cannot have a good relationship if there's pride. The Bible says pride comes before the fall. And so sometimes people are too prideful to admit that they're wrong, too prideful to say I'm sorry, too prideful to say I messed up, too prideful to say, you know what, I made a mistake, please forgive me, too proud to say, you know what, I was wrong. And when you're in a relationship, a healthy relationship, it's going to take some, it's going to take where both people go back to humility, okay? It's going to take where two people are not prideful, that they're going to be patient with one another. They're going to be kind. They're not going to be envious. They're not going to boast. And therefore, they're not going to be too prideful to say, I'm sorry. Too prideful to say, I'm wrong. But when you're dealing with a narcissistic, toxic individual, they normally don't say that they're wrong or they're sorry about anything, and when they do, they will still justify it and say, well, if you had not made me do X, then I would not have done Z. That is not humility. That is not acknowledging that you're wrong. That is pride. We should never be too prideful to say, I'm sorry. Too prideful to say, I'm wrong. Too prideful to let go of the ego. Just and let go of the ego because you know that it's affecting someone else. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be back in just a moment. Well, I guess we're not going to be back in just a moment on that one. Okay, I do apologize for that. We're going to take another song.
I'm grateful, Jesus.
It's a mystery to me, now I'm glad to see.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
When all hope was gone, you loved me.
Lord, you gave me a song.
You gave me a song and you loved me.
I'll never forget you, Jesus.
Now I can go on cause you love me.
It's a mystery.
There's a mystery to me. Now I'm blessing Jesus.
I'll love you, Jesus. And now I know.
What it really means.
Your love is everlasting. Thank you, Jesus.
What it really means to love.
Your love endureth forever. Thank you, Jesus.
To love.
No one can love me like you do, Jesus.
To love.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
I love you, Jesus. You hold me. And you keep me. Yes, you do, Jesus. You wipe the tears. Searching for. You don't have to look any further. The love of Jesus is all you need. GP.
That's love, and that is by Kirk Franklin, Love. And we all need love, but you want to make sure that you get love in the right place. And if you say, well, you know what, I don't have anyone that loves me, guess what? I love you, and God does too. Love, it does not dishonor others. And what that means is you don't do things to cause someone pain. You don't do things to cause embarrassment. You don't do things to try to belittle someone or their reputation. You don't do things that would dishonor that individual. And when you're dealing with abusers and toxic individuals, that's what they do. They will dishonor other people. In verse 5, we're still 1 Corinthians 13 and verse 5, it also says that love is not self-seeking. And when you're dealing with narcissists, they are always about themselves. Me, 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 I. They don't care who they walk over or who what they have to do to get what they want or to manipulate to get who they want. They always, it's all about me and I instead of we. And let me just say this. You have those that are narcissistic, have narcissistic traits, but they may not be full-blown narcissists, but they might be about themselves, self-centered. You don't want to be with someone that is all about themselves. You want someone to appreciate and value you just like you appreciate and value them. There's this saying, don't be someone's option when you're their priority. Let me make sure I say that right. Do not allow yourself to be someone's option when they're your priority. What that means is you're putting your all into this relationship, but that person can care less about you. You want someone that's going to be equally concerned, equally caring, equally loving, equally giving for you as well. And all the times you may, and this doesn't mean that even if you have friends, it doesn't mean that you're going to talk every day, because, you know, many of us have busy lives. And even if you talk once a year, you just want to make sure that you're in loving relationships, caring relationships, and those relationships will thrive. Another thing, when it says, the Bible says, it is not easily angered. You have a lot of people that got anger issues. And if you are their punching bag, guess what? They don't love you, because you can't love someone and you're hurting them. You don't know what love is if you're hurting someone, if you're causing them pain, if you're doing anything that's making that person shed tears. And because of your behavior, that person needs to go get help. That person needs to make sure that they get the help that they need, so that they won't cause you or other people pain. Love, it keeps no records of wrong. And let me just say, when you're dealing with narcissists, we always talk about your Miranda rights. You have the right to remain silent. Anything that you say can and will be used against you in the court of the narcissist. Because why? Narcissists keep records of everything. I'm talking about, you tell them something, they're going to put it into their vault so that they can use it on you later. And this is why you have to be careful about what you say to people, especially when you're dealing with toxic, abusive individuals or narcissists. They will use what you say against them, against you, and bring it back. It be the most innocent of things. It may not be even anything that was major, but they will try to use it against you to hurt you. So they if they feel that you have hurt them at any point, they will throw it up in your face. Now, you might think that you have gotten things together. You may have begged their pardon or forgiveness. You may have thought that you all have moved on, and the narcissist will go into their vault, take it back out, and use something against you that happened in 1774, okay, 1776, 1995, or whatever the case may be. So real love does not keep record of wrong. If someone has done something to you and they ask you to forgive them, and you know that this person has really tried to change their ways, forgive them. That doesn't mean throwing it back up because you think you got something to hold over their head. That is not love. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in truth. And one thing we know about abusers and narcissists, they can't handle the truth. It's just like that movie, A Few Good Men, with Tom Cruise and Jack Nicholson. When Jack Nicholson was on the stand, he was like, you can't handle the truth. And that is the truth. Narcissists can't handle the truth. They can't handle the truth about themselves. They can't handle the truth of who they really are. They can't handle the truth that they are flawed individuals that aim to hurt other people. They can't handle the truth. So therefore, they will flip the script and make it seem as if it's you, when it's actually them that is the one that are being the abusers. They're the ones that's doing the manipulation, the ones that is trying to gaslight you to make you doubt your reality. Love, it always protects. That means that when I love someone, I'm going to protect them from hurt, from harm. And that includes even from myself. I'm not going to try to hurt them. This makes me remember the series of The Incredible Hulk. And when he would say, when someone did something to him, and he would say, you know, you wouldn't like me when I'm angry. And so he was trying to protect them, let them know, hey, don't do that, because when I get angry, I'm out of control. You don't harm someone that you claim to love. It's actually the opposite. You try to protect them. We're going to take another quick break, and we'll be back in just a moment.
I've run out of answers. I've run out of time. And I'm so confused that I'm losing my mind. It's gonna take a miracle to help me this time. I'm traveling a road that has not one sign. Angel down. Oh, see, I
I'm carrying a load that's too heavy for me. Have nowhere to go, so I'm down on my knees. I'm trying to see the forest, but there's this one tree. Can't understand why I'm sinking so deep. Help me, help me. Won't you have mercy? Set my soul free, please. And let the bell in my heart ring. Oh, this is my cry.
And that is Reuben Studer. I need an angel. And sometimes you need that person that you can talk to, that's your angel that you can talk to, and that person that'll be there for you to help you to just get through the hard times, and not someone that's going to encourage you to stay in harmful relationships or do things that's going to cause you even more pain, but someone that can be there to be a pillar for you, and that is your angel. In verse 7, it says, "It always protects, always trusts, always harms, always hopes, always hopes, always perseveres." And when you're talking about love, trust is earned. It's not an automatic right. And when a person has broken that trust, it's hard to get that trust back. And so even if you're in a relationship that's not abusive, but you're going through some difficulties and there may have been some trust broken, then it takes time to get it back. But it can if both people work hard at it. It always hopes, always perseveres. It means that it doesn't give up. Love, true love, doesn't give up. True love actually hopes for the best. And when you have two people that are working for that love, when they truly do love each other, then it will persevere. Everyone needs love. We have basic needs like food, air, water, companionship, not just in marriages, but just being around people. Those are basic needs that we have. But one thing, we all need love. And it may not be from the person you wanted or whatever the case may be when it comes to a relationship, but you want to make sure that if you are in a relationship, that it is a loving relationship, not an abusive one, but a loving relationship. I want to, before we end today's podcast, I want to make sure that I give you the information to the National Domestic Violence Hotline. And you can go to their website at www.thehotline.org, www.thehotline.org. You can also call 1-800-799-SAFE. That's 1-800-799-7233. TTY callers, 1-800-787-3224. You can also text the word START to 88788. Again, text the word START, that's START, to 88788. There are advocates there for you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And you do not have to feel like you are alone. You can always talk to someone and get someone. If you're in a dangerous situation, please get help as safely as possible. All right, we are up out of here. I pray that today's podcast has been a blessing to you and that you know your feelings do matter.
We want to thank you for taking the time to join us today on Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help you admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Until next time.